Let me begin with the just concluded visit of President of Tajikistan, His Excellency Iman Ali Rahmon, to Pakistan at the invitation of Prime Minister Imran Khan. During his two-day official visit, President Rahmon met with the President and the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi also called on President Rahmon. During these meetings, the two sides exchanged views on deepening bilateral cooperation in diverse areas including political, economic, trade, investment, energy, security, defense, culture, education, and regional connectivity. The two sides also discussed the regional situation in detail. A number of agreements and memoranda of understanding in the areas of education, trade and commerce, anti-corruption, prevention of emergency situation, art and culture, and connectivity were also signed during the visit. Pakistan and Tajikistan share common views on major regional and international issues and cooperate closely at various multilateral fora, including the United Nations, OIC, and SCO, of which Tajikistan is the current chair. Both Pakistan and Tajikistan are part of the Kasa 1000 transmission line project along with Kyrgyz Republic and Afghanistan. The visit of the Tajik president to Pakistan is in line with Pakistan's vision of enhancing strategic partnership with the Central Asian states for regional connectivity and integration. We believe the visit by President Rahmon, his eighth since 1994, will help further strengthen brotherly ties between Pakistan and Tajikistan. President of the 75th session of the United Nations General Assembly, Mr. Volkan Bozkır, visited Pakistan from 26th to 28th of May 2021. Mr. Bozkır held detailed talks with the foreign minister and called on the president and the prime minister of Pakistan. During these meetings, a wide range of issues were discussed pertaining to regional and international peace and security, sustainable development, economic recovery efforts in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, and key items on the UN agenda, including Palestine, Jammu and Kashmir dispute, Afghan peace process, illicit financial flows from proceeds of crime, corruption, and bribery, and the UN reforms. President Dr. Arif Alvi also conferred upon the President of the UN General Assembly the award of Hilal-e-Pakistan. Prime Minister Imran Khan participated in the NICAI's 26th Conference on Future of Asia as a keynote speaker. The theme of the conference was Shaping the Post-COVID Era, Asia's Role in the Global Recovery. In his address, the Prime Minister underlined the challenges as well as the opportunities presented by COVID-19 pandemic. He underscored the need to act collectively to ensure the availability of vaccines for everyone, everywhere, and as soon as possible. The Prime Minister also reiterated the call to provide low-income countries and others in financial distress with the fiscal space and liquidity to respond to the impact of the pandemic and revive growth and stability. At the invitation of his Iraqi counterpart, Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi visited the Republic of Iraq from 28th to 30th of May. During the visit, the two sides held detailed discussions on a number of issues, including bilateral relations, as well as global and regional issues of mutual interest. Both sides also reviewed cooperation in multilateral organizations, particularly the United Nations and the Organization of Islamic Cooperation. Foreign Minister Qureshi also called upon the President of Iraq and had meetings with the Prime Minister, the Foreign Minister, the Minister of Interior, and the Minister of Defense of Iraq. During his meetings, Foreign Minister Qureshi particularly discuss issues pertaining to the management and well-being of thousands of Pakistani Zairin visiting Iraq every year. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi received the Speaker of Afghanistan's Volisi Jirga, Mr. Rahman Rahmani. The Foreign Minister highlighted Pakistan's constructive efforts for facilitating the Afghan peace process and reaffirmed its support for a peaceful, stable, democratic, sovereign, and prosperous Afghanistan. The Foreign Minister underlined the need to be vigilant about the role of spoilers both within and outside Afghanistan. He also stressed the need to utilize the available forums, including the Afghanistan-Pakistan Action Plan for Peace and Solidarity, to address all bilateral issues. The fourth session of China-Afghanistan-Pakistan Foreign Ministers Dialogue is scheduled to be held today in a virtual format. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi, State Consular and Foreign Minister of China Wang Yi, and Foreign Minister of Afghanistan Mohammad Hanif Atmar will participate in the session. The trilateral mechanism was established in 2017 to foster closer cooperation among the three countries regarding the Afghan peace process and provide assistance to Afghanistan for its reconstruction and development. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi addressed the Foreign Affairs Committee of the European Parliament at the invitation of its chair, MEP David McAllister, on 26 May. He underscored the importance of regular parliamentary exchanges between Pakistan and the European Union. In his remarks, Foreign Minister Qureshi dilated upon various aspects of Pakistan-EU relations and regional as well as international developments. He stated that Pakistan-EU strategic engagement plan has ushered in a new phase in the partnership by providing a solid foundation and framework for multilateral cooperation between the two sides. In line with the Engage Africa initiative of Pakistan, the Foreign Minister led Africa Day celebrations in the country. The Foreign Minister offered his congratulations to the chairperson of the African Union and the member countries. He reiterated Pakistan's desire to enhance economic and diplomatic engagement with Africa. In the same spirit, Pakistan has opened 5 new ambassadorial missions in the African continent. The year 2021 marks the 70th anniversary of establishment of diplomatic ties between Pakistan and China. To commemorate the 70 years of brotherly relations between the two countries, a number of events are being organized both in Islamabad as well as in Beijing. A joint virtual reception was held in this regard on 21st May. The reception was attended by President Dr. Arif Alvi, Chairman and Deputy Chairman of the Senate of Pakistan, Chairman Joint Chiefs of Staff Committee, Federal Ministers, Foreign Secretary, and other senior officials. In the same regard, Foreign Secretary Suhail Mahmood also participated in the book launching ceremony of Higher Than Karakoram at the Institute of Strategic Studies, Islamabad. The Foreign Secretary appreciated that over the past 7 decades, Pakistan-China relations had grown from strength to strength, unaffected by the vicissitudes of time and changes in the regional and global environment. On 28 May, Russia Ka Special Economic Zone under the Transformational China-Pakistan Economic Corridor was inaugurated by Prime Minister Imran Khan. The tremendous progress made in the CPEC projects signals the shared commitment of Pakistan and China. In a short span of time, we have completed 19 projects, 28 are under construction, while 41 are in the pipeline. Over the past 7 years, CPEC projects have created more than 26,000 jobs and have boosted local power industry in Pakistan. In addition, CPAC motorway projects have created over 50,000 jobs. Both Pakistan and China remain committed to the CPAC for quality economic growth and enhanced regional connectivity. Now, coming to the situation in Palestine, while the ceasefire announcement on 21st May in the occupied Palestinian territories is a welcome development, we once again reiterate the need for permanent resolution of the Palestine issue. Pakistan believes that a viable, independent, and contiguous Palestinian state based on internationally agreed parameters with the pre-1967 borders and Al-Quds Al-Sharif as its capital is the only way forward to the Palestinian issue. Pakistan, on behalf of the OIC, had requested to convene a special session of the United Nations Human Rights Council, which was held on 27th of May. The Council session led to the adoption of a resolution to establish a standing international commission of inquiry to investigate the human rights violations by Israel. The resolution represents global resolve to end systematic impunity and injustice and begin a process of meaningful accountability for the crimes committed by Israel. Now, coming to the situation in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir, it has been 22 months since the unprecedented military siege, communication blockade, and suspension of fundamental freedoms in IIOJK. The lives and livelihoods of the Kashmiri people have been severely affected in the aftermath of India's illegal and unilateral actions of 5th August 2019. India also continues with its design to change the demographic structure of the occupied territory in violation of international law, including the 4th Geneva Convention. India has already issued over 3.4 million fake domicile certificates. The martyrdom anniversary of the two slain women of Shopian, Asia and Nilofa, was observed throughout the occupied territory of IIOJK. Once again, an impartial probe was demanded into the rape and murder of the two at the hands of the Indian occupation forces in Shopian 12 years ago. India continues to employ rape, torture, degrading treatment, and killing of Kashmiri women as instruments of state terrorism in the occupied territory. India's gross and systematic violations of human rights in the occupied territory and lack of accountability of the perpetrators of these crimes have been widely documented by a number of independent commissions, human rights organizations, global media and civil society organizations, including the United Nations Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights. The continuing Indian crimes against the Kashmiri people must serve as a solemn reminder to the international community of its collective responsibility to hold India accountable for its crimes against the Kashmiri people. I thank you very much, and I'm happy to take questions on these or other foreign policy related developments.